Hey guys, welcome back to Ganchi Plans. Today's video is not like a top five recommended baby products, but it's five baby products that you may not have seen listed in all of your other lists and videos and stuff that you've been doing research for what to get for a new baby. These are five unconventional or slightly different baby product recommendations. Hopefully this video will give you some ideas to think about when you're making that baby registry or looking at getting a gift for a new mom in your life. Now, everybody who has a baby has like a whole pile of swaddle blankets, the traditional kind that you wrap up like a burrito, and it's very complicated and difficult to do in the middle of the night. So you'll see a lot of recommendations for the Velcro kind that will wrap up. You'll see like the summer infant swaddle me's with like the Velcro. There's a Halo sleep sack that has a swaddle, all with Velcro. Velcro has its place, right? It is very noisy in the middle of the night though, and it's actually more complicated than this guy, which I have not seen mentioned as much. This is the summer infant swaddle pod, which you can see is just a little cocoon that zips up, that zips that baby in there nice and secure, and it is a single step. You can't mess it up. It's the easiest thing in the world, and I don't see these mentioned enough. So I want to tell you about the good news of the swaddle pod. The best feature of this is that it not only zips up, but it actually will then unzip from the bottom so that you can change a diaper in the middle of the night without unswaddling the arms and causing that Moro reflex to trigger. Which brings us to the second item on my unconventional baby list. The conventional wisdom you hear is zipper sleepers, no buttons, no snaps, no snaps, zippers only, no snaps. Well, I'm here today to defend the snap pajama. Personally, I prefer it. Now, I hear that there is a mythical kind of pajama that has a zipper that's also reversible, like the swaddle pod has, that'll zip from the bottom. If you can find that, that's great. I don't have any of those. What I do have is normal zipper ones, where you would have to undo the entire swaddle to get to the diaper, or snap pajamas, which you can just unsnap the bottom, leave the top of the baby nice and toasty cozy, and not have to expose their chest to the cold night air. If you're using the swaddle pod with snap jammy, you don't even have to unswaddle their arms. And everyone stays a little bit calmer overnight and hopefully goes back to sleep a little bit sooner. Now the next product, you may have heard of the Wubbanub. It's been making the rounds lately. It's the stuffy attached to a pacifier. So the idea is you have the stuffy, you can grab it and the baby can grab it, and it has a little bit of extra weight. It just makes it easier to keep this passy in the baby's mouth, or for them to, even as they get older, grab it and insert it themselves. This is not a Wubbanub. This is better than a Wubbanub. This is a Nookums, and it doesn't have the pacifier sewn in. It just has this little connector that is like a universal adapter that you can connect to any major brand of pacifier on the market, even the Soothies. You can take the pacifier off, clean it in the dishwasher. You can replace it with, you know, an older pacifier, a different style if they start liking Mams instead. And it just makes it a lot easier to separate the two, and you don't have to like buy a whole new stuffy, which just seems wasteful. Nookums, they're actually, if I recall, they're comparable in price. They're either a dollar more or a dollar less. I think that it's worth looking into those instead. My next recommendation is actually a toy. You're not going to see this on any newborn registry checklists because it's really not a newborn toy. This is the Leapfrog My Pal. This one is the Scout. We also have the Violet because two different people gifted our family the two different versions of this. And this is like a customizable toy. You teach it your child's name and it sings songs and plays games with them and stuff. But one feature is on the foot here, it plays bedtime music. And the thing that's nice about that, I find bedtime music often does a good job of soothing the baby to sleep. And there's like a bedtime music setting on like the sound machines that you have, but that will just play Brahms' Lullaby on like a 10-second loop all night long. And as an adult, there's really not that much of that that you can take. What this does is it just plays through either 5, 10, or 15 minutes of a variety of different songs, in, you know, instrumental songs, and then turns off. So I find that this is a really great addition to your bedtime routine if you're trying to establish a good bedtime routine with your 3 or 4 month old, working up to doing some sleep training. That's what we did. Of course, even if you don't sleep train, it can be a great addition to your bedtime routine because the baby starts to associate those sounds of those songs in that order with falling asleep. And then there's actually somebody, some angel from above, who put the whole 15 minutes of the bedtime music on YouTube with a black screen, so you can even pull that up when you're on the go. Once with my daughter, she was crying in the back seat. I knew she was tired. I pulled that up and put it on the auxiliary cable on my phone, played that through the car, and she was asleep by the end of it. So I think that this guy is really great. And then, of course, as they get older, they can play the games and play with the songs. And my daughter has some adorable dance moves now at 2 years old. My pal, Violet or Scout. And then the last unconventional baby or newborn hack kind of a product that is on my list is not a particular brand of anything. I got these off Wish for like zero money forever ago. It's just a pair of Bluetooth headphones. They can be any old brand, and like I said, these ones are super cheap. So the beauty of these things, late night feedings, long, boring periods of time where you're trying to nurse or soothe a fussy baby. You don't want to turn on sounds that are going to wake up the baby or bother anyone else in the house. These things are great because you can turn on your podcast, set it over there, not be distracted by your phone while you gaze lovingly into your daughter's eyes and hear all about whatever 99% Invisible is telling you about this week. Love that show. Bluetooth headphones. It's very simple, and I am loving the convenience of these. So, those are my 5 unconventional baby product recommendations. I'm Rebecca, this is Bridget, and this is Genchi Plans. So if you're at the end of this video, you're not subscribed yet, please consider tapping that button at the bottom, hitting that bell. I've been posting a lot of videos about our newborn journey. She's my second. I also do mostly planner-related content on Thursdays, so I will see you for the next video on Thursday, where I will show you all of our planning process. See you then. Bye.